Yeah. Go in the shelter. Bore da and croeso cynnes i'r Railforth Tallinn. Good morning and welcome to the Tallinn Railway. I'm Stuart Williams, I'm the General Manager here. Proud to be the General Manager of the world's first preserved railway. So we're going out to a larger audience today because today is a special day. It is St David's Day, or in Welsh it's Gwyl Dewi. And obviously a very special day for all Welsh people, especially if they might have enjoyed the rugby on the weekend. We won't talk about that. So, Tallinn Railway, if you don't know Tallinn Railway, we have been running since 1865 continuously, and we've been preserved for coming up for 70 years. So we were the world's first preserved railway. And you join us at Pendray, which is the original home of the railway, our engineering works, and a very historic, we think it's the longest continuously used railway shed in the world. We could be proved otherwise, but we'd like to say we think that. And Pendray is the heart of our operation. This is where we maintain all the rolling stock and the trains. And we are one of the great little trains of Wales. So we're going to show you a little bit of what we do and a sneak preview behind the scenes today for St David's Day. So come on through into our running shed. This is the running shed where we keep the locals that are about to go out into service. And obviously they've not been out for a little while now. We've been in lockdown. But a very historic place, full of patina and soot and dirt and all the good things you get from an engineering works. So, front of the queue is Tom Rolt. Tom Rolt is our most modern steam loco, built in 1991 here. And behind it is a much more historic loco. And I'm going to get somebody to talk about that, because my colleague is here. Once Luke catches us up. Chris Smith is our engineering manager. Bore da, Chris, am I?
Morning.
And we're both wearing our daffodils with pride, and Chris was so pleased to have to put that on. So, Chris, you're in charge of this historic place.
Lucky me.
Lucky you. Do you want to tell us a little bit about Dolgoch and its origins?
Yeah, Dolgoch was built up in Whitehaven by Fletcher Jennings in 1866. It came down here for built specifically for this railway. It's always operated on this railway. It's the only engine in actually in working order when the society took over in 1951, when they started the it was the world's first preserved railway. Very historic machine. There's no others in of this type anywhere else. There's some similar ones, but not exactly the same. Means a lot to the railway. It's very historic. It still works. It still does the job it's asked to, and in fact, it pulls heavier trains now than it used to. This has been here running up and down this valley since 1866, other than when it was under repair.
So the railway, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, was the first railway to be narrow gauge railway to be built for steam hauled traction from day one, wasn't it?
Just say yes.
Yeah, that's it. Just say yes. Yeah, the Festiniog was gravity and horse worked, whereas we were our little slate railway was always steam works from the outset.
Sure.
With this engine and number one, Tallaglen.
And this railway was built primarily to haul slate from the top of the line, because we've got a 7.25 mile line, which is a long way in a steam engine. And there's a quarry, Bryngeglois quarry, at the top, and the slate from that was brought down the line. Further on than this is our wharf station, and it's called wharf because the slate was taken from the wharf onto the main line and then shipped all around the world out of Abu Dhabi. So although it was slate, there was also passenger services from, well, not straight away, but pretty much early days, 1866, passenger services started. And back in those days, a 15-mile-an-hour steam train was the quickest way to get up the valley, wasn't it? So what other toys have you got in here that you can... Well, let's have a look at number three, but you can talk about Toby as we go by as well.
Okay, yeah, this is our motor trolley. This was built on John Bates' parents' driveway way back in the mid-1950s, and railway travel was a lot more prevalent for goods in those days, so actually was taken down to the local station and put on the back of a wagon and brought up to Towyn from Surrey by rail. Whereas nowadays you'd use a lorry, unfortunately. But what it's used for is it's got a little diesel engine. It's just been refurbished, and we use it for going up and down the railway. It's very handy. You can put your tools on there and stop by the lineside cabinets. Good fun to drive as well. So it's got a mechanical gearbox chain drive to the wheels. So
rapid reaction force.
Rapid response.
Yeah. Okay, so and the top of the shed here is Sir Hayden, which is local number three to us. To the Reverend Audrey fans, you'd know it as Sir Handel. This one's got Coruscant. Do we need to give it back?
There are some fellas that say, oh, you've stolen our engines, but what actually happened was, unfortunately, the Coruscant Railway closed and these two engines were squirreled away around the back of the station at Mahuncliffe and evaded the scrap man, and the hope was that the Talithin would have them, and of course the Talithin did get going again. These are a suitable gauge to fit on our track, which is unusual. It's a 2-foot 3-inch gauge distance between the rails, and there was only the Corus Railway with locomotives and coaches of the same gauge. So had the Talithin not come into existence, this would probably have been scrapped. But nowadays, I mean, the Corus Railway is being rebuilt, and they're actually building a brand new replica of this engine, and it's almost finished.
So this was completely overhauled in 2018. Time flies, doesn't it? 2018, wasn't it? Yeah. By one of our other great little train colleagues in Aberystwyth, the Vale of Rydal Railway, who did a smashing job. We haven't had to send it back for any warranty repairs yet, so they're quite a good job. So we're just going to wander into the main workshop, which is not a hive of activity because it's tea break time. And just... So, Christopher, the history of this place was that this was the works, that was the running shed. The top end of the running shed was actually the engineer's cottage. And then the little shed at the back you can't see was where the locals were... carriages were built. So how much bigger has it got since 1865?
It hasn't. This is this original stone building is as it was. As I say, as Stuart says, the cottage had been knocked out and the locomotive shed's a bit longer because of that. But the actual building, this is the same building that that our engines have been maintained in since 1865, which is quite a feat.
So back in 1865, how many engines?
They had two engines, a fleet of slate wagons, and five carriages.
And now?
Now we've got six steam engines, four diesels, 23 carriages, I believe, and an awful lot of wagons. Yes. So we're trying to maintain more rolling stock than they did in the former times.
If Luke has a bit of a pan round, you can see that it's definitely a quart into a pint pot, but it's got lots of, should we call it, atmosphere? Is that a good way of describing it? Yeah.
On the cold winter days, there's loads of atmosphere. It all blows in through the windows and through the roof and the holes. Yeah.
So this green engine here, Chris, this looks the same as the one we've just seen, but this one's a little bit more special. This is Edward Thomas, who was the first general manager of the railway, I believe, wasn't it? So if I play my cards right, I might get a local named after me one day. But I see 1921 on this. There must be something significant this year.
Well, I'm not too bad at maths. I reckon that's 100 years, don't you? Yep. So it's a centenary, so we're making a bit of a fuss of it, really, because there's another version of this engine. The Corus people, as I say, they're building a replica of the number three, and they've already built one of these. This is a Kerr Stewart tattoo class loco. They've built it from new, and it's been running over the other side of the valley in Corus. So this year, their engine is going to come to us, and this our engine is going to go to them. So we'll have them two running together, which will be quite nice.
And further to that, 70 years ago in two weeks' time, we're celebrating with hopefully this loco and number three being out, because it celebrates 70 years since they arrived from Macunthlough to Tarryn Wharf and were brought by British Rail back in the day where British Rail could actually do some movements on freight. Okay, well, that's just a very whistle-stop tour of our works here. If you've never come to the Tarleton Railway, we operate usually, when it's not COVID-related, we'll be operating daily, and we have a lovely trip up what is the Faddo Valley. It's lovely scenery in southern Snowdonia, a very relaxing ride, some beautiful walks and waterfalls and all sorts of things you can really enjoy. So I should try and make a way one day and come and visit us, because it is a very special place and we'll give you a warm welcome. I think that's all we have to say really on St David's Day. It's nice to catch up and update, and if you want to follow us on Facebook or social media, then we do these quite regularly and you'll see that we become comedy genius. We don't wear flowers that often, but we'll be doing one, as I say, on the 17th of March. We'll do another live event and we'll actually have a steam engine in steam, won't we, Mr. Engineering Manager?
Yes, certainly, definitely.
Yes, definitely. Okay, so thanks for joining us today. Happy St. David's Day. Diolch yn fawr iawn. Iti. Diolch.
What he said.